Adventures of ArachnoFly. Clone Alone 2. Clone, sweet clone.
Have we read Clone Alone 1?
I doubt it matters.
We join the airborne arachnid as he patrols Serial City, looking for crime to stop or prevent, because he's a hero. Fortunately, he won't have to search for long. Ha! Yep, looking suitably heroic. Thank you. Wait, I know you. Aren't you my clone?
That's me?
Wow, I'd almost forgotten I had a clone. What have you been up to? Well, I have my own spin-off comic now. I go by the name The Airborne Arachnid. Hence the new look. I like it very much.
Don't forget about me!
Ha! Pea-Bean, how many times? Get out of my comic. I don't need a sidekick. I work alone. Actually, this isn't Pea-Bean. This is one of Pea-Bean's duplicates.
The best drawn one. Name's Bean Pea. And I'm cooler than Pea-Bean because my fireballs come in multiple colours! Pew, pew,
pew. Regardless, if Airborne Arachnid is anything like me, which he is because he's my clone, then he also works alone. No sidekicks. Well, actually, she is my sidekick.
What?
Yeah, we fight crime together.
We save those in need together.
We even have our own signature dance we do together. Do-ga-do-do. Ha! Teamwork!
Hee-yah!
Oh, we're so cool. Oh! Bean Pea!
Airborne! But what about your independence? Your lone perseverance? Your undiluted resolve? I was lonely. When I spun off into my own adventures, I couldn't escape the feeling that I was just you in different colours. I felt unoriginal. Then Bean Pea showed up, and I enjoyed having her around. It was nice to have a sidekick to talk to, and she helped differentiate me from you when battling Mr. Beakby. Mr. Beakby.
That's me!
Birdby! What are you up to now?
No, I am Mr. Beakby, Birdby's smarter clone.
Oh, right.
It's time to finish our fight, Airborne Arachnid. I shall meet you on the battleground.
Lead the way, you fiend! They have a pre-designated battleground.
Yeah, I love watching their battles. Oh, come on, we can take a shortcut.
Wait!
Arachnofly.
What kind of battleground is this?
Let's end this once and for all, Airborne Arachnid.
You'll never defeat me, Mr. Beakby.
Us! Never defeat us! He sometimes forgets me in the heat of battle.
It's your move. Do your worst.
Oh, I will. My rook is going to take your knight!
A big move. Are you sure you're up to it?
Absolutely! I thought we were here to watch a battle.
We are! A battle of wits!
It's surprisingly compelling once you get the gist of the rules.
Anyways, I should probably help. Come on, Airborne, you can do it. I'm here for you, buddy. You're nearly a quarter way there. I can taste the checkmate.
You know, as Birdby's clone, I know everything Birdby knows.
About you, for example.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Well, things like... You are the clone, not Airborne. And you have been all along.
What? Next time, in the Adventures of ArachnoFly.
Why can't we just punch each other repeatedly like normal?
This is an epic battle of wits. I thought we should try it out. Change of pace. Yes! A win!
Best of five?
Well, I didn't know there was a spin-off called Airborne Arachnid.
It's much cooler and more thinky than ArachnoFly.
I have a few issues you can borrow.
The Adventures of ArachnoFly!
Adventures of ArachnoFly!
Attack of the Venus ArachnoFly Trap! A poor, defenceless ant has been captured by the duplicitous bird bee!
Somebody help me!
Fortunately, help is at hand!
Let the ant go, bird bee!
Bigger ant? Sorry, no, not you.
I'd like to be rescued by ArachnoFly, actually. I should have specified.
Oh, okay. You sure?
Yeah, sorry.
Fair enough.
Help me! Help me! ArachnoFly!
Fortunately, help is at hand. Let the ant go, Birdbee!
If you say so.
Oh, great. That was easy.
One P, as agreed.
Well, we agreed double if I pretended to be distressed.
Hmm. Fine.
Wait! That hand didn't need my help!
Well observed. She was just bait to lure you to my lair. Now you are here. Prepare to face my Venus Arachnofly trap!
Hmm?
Go on.
Go on what?
You need to land on her open mouth, or at least fly close enough for it to close around you on my command.
I'm not doing that.
But it won't work if you don't.
Oh, I thought I was going to have an epic fight with a monstrous mutant Venus flytrap. This doesn't look anything like the one on the cover.
What one on the cover?
Come on, I'll show you. See? This one's got proper teeth and a tongue and tentacles. Much more impressive. I want to fight this one.
Well, you can't.
Da-da-da! I'm not just going to land in its mouth and let it eat me.
It probably won't hurt. She's not going to chew you. Just slowly digest you.
I'm not really feeling the Venus flytrap thing, so I'll come back for your next evil scheme. I need to stop.
Please. She'll die if you don't.
What do you mean?
I created her with just one dietary need. Arachnofly.
What? Why?
Mainly to see if I could.
Typical. And I suppose you didn't stop to think whether or not you should, did you?
No. She can't survive on anything else, and I've become quite fond of her.
Gah. Fine, I'll help. But for her, not for you.
Brilliant. In you go.
Obviously, I'm not going to feed myself to her. Just wait here while I go do some arachno science in my arachno lab.
Can you do it in a montage?
Yes, obviously. Whipple. Web blob. Web spoon. Web baking tray. Here you go. I've created the solution. Web sweeties! Made from my own web and some other stuff. It should provide a growing Venus arachnofly trap with all the arachnofly nutrients it needs.
Oh, she loves it. I want to thank you, but you are still my nemesis, so I won't.
Next time in the Adventures of Arachno. No way. I'm not going to let a good cover go to waste. Prepare for battle, impressive foe!
Oh no.
God, imagine if Venus flytraps were real. Terrifying.
If all you need to do to not be eaten by one is not to land on it, I think you'll be okay.
Ba-da-ba-ba-boo, ba-dee-ba-dee-ba-dee-ba-dee-ba-dee-ba-boo.